Hi everyone, welcome back. As a continuation from my previous video on scheduler getting started, now I'll let you know the way to bind appointment data to the scheduler. All you need to do to populate data to the scheduler is you have to define a model class with valid fields. So refer the built-in fields available in scheduler from here, like ID, subject, start time, end time, location, description, and so, you can see n number of built-in properties available within the scheduler. Of all these field names, ID, start time, and end time, these are the mandatory field names to be passed to the scheduler appointment data. So within the index component, now I'll introduce the code section using the @code directive. And now I'm going to create a class with the name appointment data with four fields, namely ID. So let me copy paste for the rest of the four fields, and I'll change the second field to subject, and the third field is start time, and the next field end time. In case if you want to use different names over here, then you need to bind them to the appropriate scheduler fields, which we'll see next after a couple of minutes. So for now, I'll create a list and add a couple of appointment data with those four field values. So I'll create a list of appointment data. And within this list, I have added two appointment data with these field names, ID, subject, start time, and end time. Now I need to assign this created appointment data list, that is data source, to the scheduler data source. So to define the scheduler data source, I need to define the event settings property of scheduler. So for that, within the schedule tag, I'll define schedule event settings. I'll add the property data source within this event settings, and to this data source property of scheduler, I'll assign this particular data source variable using @. So I have accessed this data source variable from the code section and assigned it to the data source property of scheduler. So let me close this event settings tag. So we have set the data source for the scheduler now. Apart from all these things, now I need to replace this object value with appointment data. So here I'll change the object value to appointment data. Now reloading the page. Here you can view the scheduler displaying two appointments on the dates January 10 and 13 respectively. In case if you are binding different field names, so now we have bind the data source with the same field name as it is given over here, ID, subject, start time, end time. In case if you are binding the field names different from these default names, then let me tell you how to bind it to the scheduler. Say for example, I'm changing the ID to event ID and subject to event subject and start time to event start and end time to event end. In the same way, I have also changed the list data field names over here. Now, as an additional step to bind these different field names to the scheduler, I need to define the schedule field property within this schedule event settings property. So schedule field, which is of type array. So here inside the schedule field property, I have mapped the field names with the name properties. So you can see here the event subject field from the model class is bind to the subject field, and in the same way event start field is mapped with the field start time, and event end is mapped with the field end time. And this event ID is an exceptional case. So to bind this event ID, ID equal to event ID, as this property can always receive only the string value, so we can map the ID field in this way to the scheduler fields. So now you can see that I have mapped four field names that are different from the default field names of scheduler. So now let's see how it works. Let me reload the page. So you can see the scheduler still displaying the appointments properly as I have mapped the field names properly at the code section. Now finally, let me tell you how to bind the appointment data from a remote service URL to the scheduler. To bind remote data, I need to make use of the data manager component of Syncfusion and assign the data source of scheduler to it. So as a first step, I'll open the imports.razor file, and here I'll need to add another namespace at using Syncfusion blazor.data. To start using the data manager component, I need to add this namespace to the imports.razor file. And then within the index component, I'll remove all these event settings related properties. And here I need to add a data manager tag within this event settings property now. So let me remove this data source property which I have defined within this event settings. So now I'll add the data manager tag, and I'll add the URL property and assign it with an existing service URL where the appointment data is already maintained with the same field names which I have defined previously. So let me change all these field names to my existing default field names of scheduler like this. So I'm not going to assign this list data source now, so let me remove this. This particular URL, let me show you in the browser what data it returns. So you can see here the default field names like ID, subject, start time, and end time. So apart from these four fields, you can also see some other fields. Since we have bind only these four field names to the appointment data class, so you no need to worry about the additional fields that are maintained in this URL. I need to add another property, adapter. So I'll add the property adapter and set its value to at syncfusion.blazor.adapters.webapiadapter. So I need to set this web API adapter type to the adapter property of data manager to allow the scheduler to communicate with the web API URL. And the another important point is I need to assign the same T value property within the schedule event settings as well. So that's it. Let me save the changes now. So now let me navigate to the year 2017 of June month. And here you can see the scheduler displaying the appointments that are loaded from the remote service URL. And that's really the basic features that you all need to know while starting to work with the Blazor scheduler of Syncfusion. Now let me summarize what we have seen so far. We have seen the steps to create a Blazor server app project and how to import the Syncfusion Blazor assemblies. Then we saw how to add a Blazor scheduler component to the application along with few of its important features. You can download this featured example from the link provided in the below description. And if you find this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notified of our new videos. Thank you for watching.